All right, so when we're looking at the week of March 23rd through the 29th, 2012. Now, we've got the Sun is in Aries and Mars is in Virgo. Mars is retrograde. Now, Aries is kind of like a restless child. And all it knows is it needs to suck teeth. It needs to go for the breast, you know, and have some good milk. And, you know, our most basic needs as humans are put on the line by Aries time. You know, we've had enough of the cold, wet winter. And, you know, we're ready to eat the miner's lettuce that's growing out of the ground or whatever local spring-type things that are coming up. And it's also a time when the moisture picks up in a lot of places and grains go rancid, you know, from the year before. So we have Passover, and it's a time when it's not necessarily good to eat grain so much, you know. Eating vegetables and good quality protein keeps people healthier, generally speaking. So, you know, what we have right here, right now, is this time to say to ourselves universally, we're doing something new. We just started a new moon cycle. We're in Aries, the newest, freshest sign in the zodiac. And we've got a retrograde Mars. And, you know, sometimes I check in with my Eastern astrologers from Vedic traditions, the Jyotishis, and they're saying, you know, this is a time, kids, be really careful. Nature and rash forces are set loose, you know, so between wars, volcanoes, earthquakes, bizarre snowstorms and storms, in general, you gotta be ready, you know, at all times. And the best thing to do is appreciate your neighbor, because I think a lot of times when we get a lot of planets in Aries and Taurus, you know, there's a lot of a me first, very selfish kind of energy. And so that needs to be chilled with that wisdom, you know, that we get from Saturn and Libra, let's say. It's like, hey, we're not the only ones on the block, you know. Everyone's got to thrive and survive. Even Pluto and Capricorn, it's like, you know what, this money stuff is worthless if we can't sustain ourselves as humans in the human family. So I think whenever you get a small frustration, number one, I want to say to you, you know, it's common this time of year in Aries time. The other thing is that this frustration is probably an opportunity. It's that flat tire on your bike that makes you find the $100 bill on the ground. You know, if you never had that frustration, you wouldn't have looked around and seen how rich you were. So let's like break it down to that. Let's give hope and encouragement to each other. And I look forward to being with you next week when we do this again on the Planetary Persuasion.